Oh well, as many people as there is, I don't think you'll find me. I guess he wants me to go down there. Let's see. damn it. No place to put it. Going to ran over. It's getting some good shots. See? It's got everything. It's
got everything. I don't know what this thing was. Maybe I ain't checked the battery maybe did. I
charged everything up, including this, last night.
Well, my grandkids are close to here, okay. But I told them to put oil in the space straight.
Let's take it out, but it's waterproof. You can take it underwater.
Yeah, yeah,
actually. I'm not going to be underwater, but you never know.
Do you ride right on there? They're hunting right.
I don't have
them.
Huh?
You ride right on there. Those are
right
names right there.
Maybe next year.
They sure appreciate you. They like to have all them shears filled up, see? But I'm on the walk. They need. I ain't got nobody that's probably able to walk, you know.
I am going to take pictures, and I'm going to put them on the internet. See, I'm on YouTube on my own YouTube channel. And last year there was none of us online. I'm going, no, Plainview's got to be going on. You know.
See what this will do? He'll go up to the library.
Yeah.
He'll go right in front of the police station. Broadway, it'll come back down and they'll leave this load there, or they did last year, right in the middle of the street. This is Broadway, see, right there, right across and all that corner right there, and they have all kinds of food and free ice cream and everything there. They'll bring this coat right up there, and then they sell t-shirts for fun, but see, this is that, yeah. This is that float. It's the sports troops, you go to Washington. And you figure 52 veterans at $1,600 better, and it takes many a dollar to get that fly out off the ground, sir.
Oh, I was trying to call you. Did you know that transgender for the military has passed, and they actually, military pays for sex change now?
Pay for what?
Sex change.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Yeah, it just come on the newspaper. I mean, on the news.
They all messed up on that deal, no.
I'm going, no, I don't know. My tax dollars is under the paper.
It will.
Some J become Joy.
Boy, that veteran, that guy, young standing for the seal.
Mm-hmm.
I talked him hard around on here. Boy, when he found out I was voting for Trump, boy, he left. He didn't hang around.
Well, we got no damn choice.
And that's 50-50. I can't. I just, in my mind, I don't know who it is, but that's not a woman's job. I don't give it.
This is not her job.
I don't care.
I still blame her for Benghazi.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
She can't even take care of four people.
I watched the movie.
She can't take care of that whole world.
They actually put it online.
They had another one. Here's a veteran. If he gets right on the float, I don't know where he can.
Yeah, you can definitely get on the float.
And he has a crippled foot. He has a crippled foot.
Well, by all means, get on the float. What's your name, sir?
Terry Pierce.
Hi, I'm Angie Nellis. I'm the peer support for the Military Veterans Peer Network.
She's a
I did bring a shirt, but he's always 40 years old.
That's okay.
It's all worn out.
You don't have to have a uniform on. No.
There you go. Here's my card.
She's one that has the thing.
Hopefully nobody stole my scooter.
Every other Tuesday night here at the out at Elks Lodge.
It's Thursday nights now.
Thursday
night. Second and fourth Thursday.
Thursday night.
I got a booth over there on the corner of 5th and Broadway, because we set up two booths, and there's a flyer of where they are. So,
I have a cane, but it's on my scooter over there.
Get in there, okay. Do you mind? Can I stand with you guys?
You met.
Make sure you get my Southern Pride.
Here we go. Let's get it. Look at this dude. Can I get one with you?
I don't care. I don't care. Man, the camera still works.
Smile.
Well, you can get in.
Smile.
Get in.
He's good.
Come back up here.
No. Park pictures.
Yes.
I take pictures. I'm not in pictures.
I didn't have time to say cheese.
Alright, so I'm just going to let this run until it runs out of space.
Okay. If you're on the float, they'll get on pretty quickly because they'll take off here and just...
I'll wait till next year.
Oh, God. You're on the float?
No, I'm
going to walk. Somebody's got to be responsible for this.
Yeah. Well, you can carry that with you.
Yeah.
Carla, talking to you. I'm Carla.
I'm Terry. Can somebody buy still my skin?
She's a service officer.
It's gotten pretty bad around here.
Well, it's getting better.
That's what we want to say, right?
Yeah. Thanks for all these people that step in and do their work.
Yeah, we work hard.
This last year, I've been exhausted for a while.
Her and I have been working hard.
And it just doesn't stop, so here we go again.
It takes everybody.
Well, I guess I could turn this off.
The guy in the white t-shirt, Hunter?
Yeah.
Okay. He was ahead of the flight when we went, Larry. But now, that other guy in the black, kind of black uniform there, I think he owns ice factory, whatever they call it, in Amarillo. He's Don Ricks. He's ahead of it now. But Larry's still hosting, I guess always will for as I know.
I know you are pretty snazzy.
Of course, you buy other stuff that's right here. I'm rolling TN and play mortgage.
Watch this, I go get my shirt. Don't let nobody steal my camera. Because actually this is a camera too. Gotta represent. I was a little guy back then.
Little guy?
Yeah, but this thing's 40 years old.
Well, back when I was in the Army, it was khaki. And I started working for the Corps at Jen at Edmondson as a boy working there.
Yeah.
I noticed he had the same pair of breeches only about a week later. And I said, do you have any change of clothes? He said, no, I don't have no change of clothes.
I sold them, thank you. You ready to go get on the floor?
Yeah, aren't
we? We need to fill our seats.
Okay.
And it's not for the
veterans.
For our veterans.
Talk me into it. I really hate to. I'm bashful type person.
Well, I know the flags will cover you.
Good. Put me where I can't cut the thing.
They got a left.
They'll hit you.
They got steps on
there.
They got steps.
Things we do for our town.
That's right. I mean, look. Can't wait for some little ladies up there. Thank you.
Oh, what am I going to say? Smile.
No problem.
Yeah. Well, Gerald needs to be up there. He looks good.
I know he does.
He got that uniform on, got his medal. It's a lot better than a 40-year-old shirt.
Larry, we need to get him up there.
Huh? Yeah, but it's kind of rotten. For 40 years, that's a long time to sit in the closet. And everything else got destroyed. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
I got it. Where's Gerald? Talk me into it. Oh, boy. Hopefully it'll stay there. That's funny. When you're 17, 18, you don't wear the same clothes as when you're 60.
Yeah.
Couldn't believe this thing survived 40 years. In the closet.
That's your original.
Yeah, that's my original.
I can't mind my son, my probably just ripped the crap.
Mine got destroyed by my mother.
I did have my boots, my jungle boots. So
yeah, still had to buy it from you. All right. It's a good deal. You need to be on. Got that nice uniform and his medal and everything.
Hey, I just love this. Race is not going to be very long. I can't imagine.
I couldn't figure out where I could set up and get the whole thing, so.
What's this deal?
20 minutes before we're supposed to start. Somebody got here a little bit early.
Are you gonna walk me to the ride?
Yeah.
Okay, then let's get one more chair.
Okay.
No. We just didn't want a bigger one.
It's not gonna walk. You got a metal plate in there. Yeah, and a pin in my ankle.
Got two plates, 23 strings in there.
It's going to be a little while before.
Yeah.
Is it a year? And then I talked to the guy at the VA, and he said it's going to be at least 2 years.
It takes a while.
Break it. Broke it.
Walk, right? I mean, not walking, but walk. Correct. Where I wasn't going to have a
not tonight, oh well. Your chair is being vacated.
You don't have to ride. Old man, he's a Marine. You bet. You don't have to ride. You can walk. If you want to ride, you can ride.
You see whose flag you're sitting beside?
Why did you decide to move up here, down here, and leave liberal?
My wife had Alzheimer's.
Oh,
and our daughter lived here for 4 years, so we moved down here so she could help me. We moved March 5th, and she died April 25th. So,
and I know it's, I know that's tough.
Well, it was 10 years. And I do for
Bill McKeever.
60 days.
I lose my scooter. Gas is too high.
Yeah, we bought a place out here. I drove the truck all my life, so wherever I hang my hat is where I'm at.
I drove a truck for 31 years.
Did you?
They told me I couldn't do it anymore.
Yeah, I drove for 33 years for one company.
Company to company, and mostly with Cargill and XL and then.
Oh, did you?
And that's what got me here. No. Oh, the dead car, cow hauler.
Yeah. Remember, they were getting us on the tail rack. Somebody had him so hard.
This is Mr. Orr. Al.
I'm Al.
My daughter, Maddie.
Glad to meet you.
Mr. Pierce.
Okay.
Are you Vietnam veteran?
Yes.
Yes. Are you Vietnam veteran?
Yeah.
Yes. I can't remember the other day when I talked to you.
Yeah.
Okay.
The old ones.
I guess it makes you Vietnam.
Yeah.
This is Ray. Ray's a Vietnam veteran, and Ray's one of the very first veterans I met when I got this job.
It doesn't matter. You go to VA.
This is the first time I've ever done anything except for the VA. I just leave people alone.
Yeah.
Because I get tired of arguments. And I don't like to argue.
I was commander of our American Legion for 10 years. So I've been involved with this VA deal ever since.
I appreciate y'all being here.
Guys come to me and we start, and I'm a post service officer too. So.
Mm-hmm. They had one, eh?
Got one open and locked me, but not here.
Yeah, well, tried to go to one in Bowie, Texas when I lived there, and it didn't work out. Too many drunks. Always wanted to fight.
Well, and that was, when I got commander up there, they elected me commander, and the guy that had been in there before. This is going to be a whole different ball game, guys. There ain't going to be any of this infighting and all this crap. This is at an end. Everything is going to be done democratically. If we vote on it and it passes, that's the way it is. If it doesn't pass, that's the way it is. I kind of laid down the law right off the bat. I never had any trouble. Well, I had one fight. Of course, you're always going to have one.
Oh, yeah.
Then you expect that. Just different personality.
Well, we just happen to have three once. You know, we call them students.
Yeah.
They can never make rank without getting busted back down.
Yeah.
They were just all three of them were just a real screw up. They did not want rank. They were happy being airmen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because less responsibility.
I had a guy that I knew that was that way too. He'd get up to being an E4 and then he'd get busted back to E1 mm-hmm. or something, you know.
These guys just...
He just wanted to get his 20 in and get the hell out. He didn't want responsibility. Did you go to Lackland?
Yeah, many years ago.
That's
I was there during the summertime, but most of the guys were Texans, and we volunteered to work outside instead of inside because we liked the warm weather.
Yeah.
And in the middle of July, you know, it was easy getting people that would flop with you.
Yeah.
We just didn't like being inside a building.
Now that's all changed down there. Now they build all the barracks. Well, they don't call them barracks. They call them something else. There's four different companies in each one of those buildings.
Damn.
Drill instructors live right in that building. I don't understand how that's all done. But
yeah, I'm really pissed off because they passed the transgender law.
Yeah.
And now, the military, the VA, will actually pay for their sex change.
Yeah.
And I'm going, oh, hell no.
Yeah, that's what they're telling on television this morning.
Jerry tried to get him to the clinic, and it's going to be a month. Mm-hmm. But yet, they got money to get, you know, sex change.
Yeah. Well, that's what pisses me off, you know. Screw the veteran around, but there's always money for nonsense.
Yeah. the dumb shit.
And, you know, somewhere down the line, this thing doesn't register to me.
And what I don't understand is they can wear turbans, beards, all this stuff. And they got mad at me because my mustache dropped. You know, one hair gets below that your lip and you're having the dry shave.
We couldn't even have a mustache.
That's all we could have is a mustache. No sideburns and definitely no beards.
We all got mohawks over there in Vietnam just for the hell of it. We had a new lieutenant come in and said, "You guys can't do this." And we said, "Oh, really?
Where does it say we can't?"
And no, it was in the Marine Corps.
Oh, really?
And we said, "Oh, okay, we can't do it. Now, what are you going to do? Send us to Vietnam? We're already here." He kind of looked a little funny and he said, "You're all going to be court-martialed." And we said, "Good, didn't you put us in the Crossbar Hotel, and that's better than being out in the boonies anyway."
Oh, yeah.
Well, nothing ever happened. The Colonel got rid of him.
Once they got all pissed off at me, and I cut it off like a Hitler, because I had a dry shave, didn't have any water. And they pissed them off. I said, "Tell me why I can't."
Yeah.
You got all pissed off about my mustache, because, you know, my mouth was so funny.
In the Marine Corps, you couldn't have any tattoos. You couldn't hide.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you had to be able to put them under your shirt.
Oh, yeah. So, the whole thing is, it's a shame. I mean, yeah, the way I look at the military now, it is really a shame, the things they've done. I still think that every young man coming out of high school should do at least a year.
Oh, I
just basic training would change for the whole life.
Well, get the idea of doing something for your country.
A purpose.
Yeah, that's what I
do. But see, even
if they can draft women too, I think women ought to have.
Oh, yeah. We had women. They did the same things we did.
Have any women, you know, we never had to put up with them. We'd see them every once in a while, you know, if you had to, "I'll go back sideline."
We had some good looking wives.
The Marine Corps, they kept them away from us, because, you know, they didn't want us having to put up with
them. They had real strict rules, but they were in some base, just the all the way on the other side.
No, were they?
But we managed.
Yeah.
We had a girl that wants to meet you halfway. He's always away.
Oh, yeah.
As long as you don't get... And it, of course, there wasn't cameras and everything like there is now everywhere.
Yeah.
Can't part without somebody knowing about it.
Yeah,
here I'm talking. I got one sitting there. Still clicking. If it really runs out of space on that disc, I just that'll be enough to
GoPro.
I want to be GoPro.
I've got one. I figured out how to use it.
Go to YouTube.
Put it up there on the dash.